So if you believed in juju or voodoo, right, you would think that one way or the other, our leaders have held Nigeria under this spell or this bond. But like I was telling my friend, it's not possible to do that to 200 million people. You know, you might do that with one or two people, but to do that to a country for how many years now since we got our independence, 1960, or let's say democracy, 1999, it's so possible. You know, you can't just hold on Nigerians under this spell, which is what our leaders have succeeded to do. You know, that's why they keep on dividing us based on tribe, based on religion. But like you talked about NSAS, that was a turning point, I believe, in Nigeria. You know, like I said, everyone came together because despite differences in race, in religion, in tribe, no one cared about any of that. All we cared about was NSAS. SAS should go. Accountability in governance, you know, better leadership at the state level, you know, and so many other things that we cared about. So I think, honestly, what Buhari has taught us as Nigerians is that because of how bad and how evil and how demonic, any word when I used to describe the guy, right? Because of how bad he is, he's been able to show us that, you know what, if we keep on letting these guys do what they're doing and get away with it, we'll never have the Nigeria of our dreams.
It will just keep getting worse.
It will keep getting worse. So I think it kind of changed our mentality that if we can only unite, because the solution is out there looking at us. God, I believe God has helped Nigerians. God has helped us already. You know, God has shown us what we need to do to get away from this. Only thing we need to do is just to grab it. It's just there waiting for us to grab it. The solution is there for us to grab it. What are the solutions? If you're eligible to contest for a position and you love Nigeria, please put yourself forward and contest. You know, state level, federal level, local level, any level, contest for a position. If you're eligible to go and vote people that you know are going to do job when they get in there. Don't vote based on...
Sorry to cut you short now. You know, I like to play devil's advocate.
Yeah.
I think in line with this thing that we're saying, that is why this thing that we're working on is going to have to make sense.
Yeah.
I think it's time to form an alliance, in a world, a global Nigerian alliance that will fund candidates. Because even if you're eligible, your chances of winning are very low.
Yeah.
If you don't have the money and you're contending with these demons in power, it is almost, I like to be real, it is almost impossible.
Yeah.
So people will need support.
Yeah, of course.
I think that is where we can unite. That's why, like, we keep contrasting this whole Biafra thing. If only Biafra was like trying to enforce good leadership and trying to prop up good leaders, or you know, fundraise for people eligible, you know, things like that, instead of just
violence
which is not leading us anywhere, sit at home, that is ruining us. So we need something that will unite Nigerians everywhere and support Nigeria, so that we cannot be the one to determine who will go into power. So if in Edo State there is an eligible youth, an eligible young candidate, instead of these very old men like Joe Biden and Buhari that will soon be going to their graves. No, that's why I like comparing two of them. I look at two of them, I be like, these people have lived their whole life, and they're now they want to ruin the lives of other people before them, because they're already in their old, their grandfathers, who may be very great grandfathers. So they've lived their life, so they don't care. So we need young. I know that not all young people are able to deliver. Some young people are even worse. But we need young people that can relate to the everyday.
Like I told you, like I told my friend, I believe in cycles. You know, I believe that our time will come. You know, these people, like you said, are gonna die, they're gonna go.
I mean,
it's a generational
thing. They don't care.
You really believe in cycles, which is, whether you're Christian or not, you know, things keep changing, things keep moving.
At some point, our generation is now.
Of course, we are the future of
tomorrow. Yeah. That tomorrow has come.
Yeah. And I believe this is with this media thing we are doing, with this stuff. I see it as something that we can use to push.
Yeah, sure. That's
push
the whole
these
idea.
Ideas and these candidates and these ideas and push it out into the world.
Yes, we need to form that huge alliance.
Because I was speaking to the guy you linked me up to, right? I don't want to call this because of security reasons, but he said any smart guy can do what another candidate did.
Of course.
And I was happy because I know we agreed on that. Because it was like what he did was to just ride a wave of people's discontent towards Nigerian leaders in power. Anybody that is smart as a brain can do that. All you need is to just speak up about this, you know. You know, and what he said was true. It was
ginger
like
people.
Ginger people up, you know, it's very easy to do that. And like he said, he's been able to do this to the level that people can even strap suicide vests on themselves just because of
the difference between these people now and the terrorists.
Yeah,
exactly. Middle Eastern terrorists.
So imagine if we are doing that, but how we are doing it on the good side.
In a productive way, because that was the question. What does he want to
achieve? You're doing fundraising for eligible candidates, you're doing
you're making campaigns,
making phone calls,
because it's time to literally because at this point, since people are fleeing Nigeria, I believe a large amount of Nigerians are now in diaspora.
Yeah, yeah.
And by God's grace, most of us are doing well, by God's grace, because a lot of Nigerians all over the country, most of these conservative self in America, they keep hyping Nigerians when they want to attack black people that are lazy. They'll be like, look at Nigerians, that are doing well, they're successful.
Yeah, yeah.
And by God's grace, we thrive wherever we go to.
Yeah,
so
course,
I think it's time for us Nigerians in diaspora
to unite
and empower Nigerians in Nigeria, because our leaders are not willing to do that. I think that's what we should do now, because if we keep waiting for these leaders, we will keep seeing the likes of Seni Fani Kayode that will change party the way he changed
and the news, Governor Wike was telling Jonathan, I think that was yesterday, I saw the news on Punch, that he shouldn't think of going to APC. And so I was thinking, right, what if he goes to APC? What would someone like a Mokri say? Because this is someone like a Mokri believes in his mind. And it's very naive idea, he believes. And for some reason, Jonathan will not change parties. So I'm like, when he does, because I believe he will, because this is politics, you know. He's going to change us, because he's been promised that when he changes, he's going to run again. Come 2 years' time. What happens to their credibility? People like what happens to his credibility? You know, because you can't just be saying things like that.
You can't tie your credibility to these people.
Yeah, you can't. You just can't. You know, it's like, oh, these guys. You can't. How can you make my friend one of Sunday when she was like, how can you say things like that to a black man, to compare someone like Jonathan to Mandela? Like I said, that's why, like, going back to tying this to our former conversation, these guys really believe in their hype. They believe in their hubris.
They're delusional.
They live in a different reality. We see that for them, because you can throw a party where 100 privileges are going to come for your son's wedding, you believe that Nigeria is good. Because you're in that space, you're living in that cocoon where there is security. You can, anything you want is at your doorstep, so you don't believe that outside that cocoon things are bad.
How can you relate to the everyday man?
You can't. And that's the point. That's why, like I said, the emperor needs people around him that can tell him the truth. People that are courageous, stand up for the common man and tell him that no, sir, things are going wrong.
But since the emperor and the people around him have failed us, let the citizens now rise.
Yeah.
So we're going to rise up against him, and by God's grace, we will win.
Yep.